Hello dear friends, welcome to Shiksha Mantra. And in our discussion here in Shiksha Mantra, we were in the middle of discussing about various verbs which are actually less heard. And in that interesting part of our discussion here, we are going to discuss about a verb which really we have heard very little of, and this verb is called ditransitive verbs. So let's begin our discussion. But before shifting to our discussion of ditransitive verbs, I would like to share with you something that is an intransitive verb. So what we get in an intransitive verb? There we get only a subject and a verb, and after the verb we don't get anything that we may call an object. That means an intransitive verb is a verb without an object. So let's have a very simple example so that we can get to it very easily. And the example is Mr. Brown teaches. So this is the verb teaches. Now who teaches? Mr. Brown. So this is the subject. So here you get only subject and verb, and there's no other information regarding this. That is, the object is missing and we consider it as an intransitive verb. So now we discuss about transitive verbs and would call them monotransitive verbs. Mono means one, so it's a single transitive. How a transitive verb gets a singularity? So let's have a look at the structure that we get. Here it is: subject, verb, and a noun or a pronoun. So it suggests the object. So in a monotransitive verb, we get only one object, that is a single object, and it makes it monotransitive. So have an example and you'd get to it very easily. And now the example is Mr. Brown teaches English. So the same sentence, that means you know this is the verb and Mr. Brown is the subject. And then Mr. Brown teaches what? You'd get the answer, that is English. So this is the object of the verb teaches. So here we get a single object. That's why this is monotransitive verb. And this is also the basic difference between transitive verb and intransitive verb. In an intransitive verb, you don't get an object, whereas in a transitive verb, you get an object. So the difference is in between having an object and don't have an object. So here we have learned about monotransitive verbs, and you have also learned that mono means one, it speaks of singularity. And now shift to our topic, that is a ditransitive verb. Now what does this di mean? Di means two. The verb is transitive but in di, that is in double sense. So how goes the construction of such sentences? So let's have a look at the construction first. Here you'd get subject plus verb plus noun or pronoun plus noun or pronoun, that is the two different object appears here with the verbs. So how is it possible? So how does it make? This is the first object and there is the second object. So one thing is clear, that here we'd get two different objects. That's why this is called ditransitive verb. So here's also an example: Mr. Brown teaches me English. And if we consider this sentence, here teaches is the verb, Mr. Brown is the subject. Now Mr. Brown teaches what? You'd get English as the object. And also Mr. Brown teaches whom? You'd get me. This is also another object. So here we'd also get two objects for this sentence, and with the two objects it would be considered as ditransitive verbs. So here you would better remember one thing, that is this object, that is English, it's considered as direct object, and me, this is considered as indirect object. So here you'd get direct object and indirect object. It's a very essential to remember properly, because you'd face these sentences in voice change where it would help you a lot. So if you haven't yet prepared for this, follow the link above. So I have a video on voice change in this channel, and I have put the link above in the I button, and from there you can check it and you can learn how to use direct verb and indirect object. So direct and indirect object together are used in voice change, and there we get retained object. So all these you'd find there in the video regarding voice change. But we are here now to learn ditransitive verbs. So how does the ditransitive verb is defined? So let's get the definition for the ditransitive verb. A ditransitive verb is one that takes both a direct object and an indirect object. So we have already discussed it, and you'd find this very much interesting because you must know how to get the direct object and the indirect object. So here we have another example. He teaches me English. So now this me, we get this but by asking the verb who. So he teaches whom? Me. And when you ask the verb with whom, you'd get the indirect object. And he teaches what? You'd get English. So with the what question, you'd get the direct object. So here for this verb, you get both an indirect object and the direct object, and that is the object number one and object number two. So two different objects, one direct and another indirect. And finally, it satisfies our definition of ditransitive verb. It's so very easy, isn't it? So if you have found it really easy and very, very simple, obviously it demands a like from your end, and with the like also you can comment on the comment box below, and also we'd expect some comments and demands from you so that we can proceed further and we get much inspiration to create many of such videos. So that's all. We'd meet again with another types of verbs, and stay tuned to Shiksha Mantra. Happy learning!